Okay, create record has been done. Now go to API player, create a new file, read.php. The code will be almost same, so just copy this create php file and paste it here. And we don't need to grab data from user in here, so just delete them, and all the value will be null. We don't need to set any value to the database. We are going to retrieve from database. We also don't need this if else statement. So for now, I'm going to just make it a comment. And above there, I'll create one more function. That function would be inside player.php. Copy this function, paste it below. This would be read and select. SQL command will be select to get data from our database. Select from name of our table. We want to select everything, so give a hash. We don't need to bind anything. For now, let's delete all of them. I think here should be a second bracket, closing second bracket. No double quotation mark since we are ending. We need to set attribute. This DBA is set attribute first variable, first parameter will be PDO colon colon A double T R underscore FAULT default. Default fetch mode, comma, fetch. Now we need to execute our statement. Execute. Here, result is equal. Fetch all, this is the function for fetching all of our data, and at very last we are going to return our result. Now go to read.php file. From here, let's create a variable player underscore result is equal player, name of our function that was read player, copy the name and paste it here as well. Print underscore R. This is the function for printing an array. Okay, so we are going to use it. Player result. Save it, open Insomnia, create a new request. This is a get request because we are getting information. We are reading our player, so it will be a read request. The copy the URL from here and paste it in the, and this would be read. That's all. Send request, it's saying something went wrong in here. Fetch object player line number 58 in player line number 58. Let's check in 58 attribute PDO. This should be PDO colon colon. Save it once again. Reload the page. and it's giving us all the data from our database, but we want to precise it, okay? Because it is coming as an array, so we are going to show how many row we have in our array. So just write count is equal count player result, and there will be our while loop. You can use for loop or do while loop, but I'm going with while loop. I is equal 0 while I is less than count, it will going to printing, okay, player array is equal array here we'll have all the messages. Message will be reading player. Below this player array, we are going to print it out. Player array semicolon, and here we need to increase our I by 1, okay? Every time it read our player, it will increase 1, so it will go to the another player. First one would be ID player result. Let's pass the loop variable, okay? So it will go to all of the player we have. ID comma copy and paste it below 3 more times. This would be name. I made a mistake here. This should be a I and this should be a comma, not semicolon, because we are reading player. And here you can see I also made a mistake, as I always do, and we don't want to print any result as array, we want to print as JSON format, JSON underscore encode, take whole array inside JSON encode. Now let's check it out. It's showing something went wrong with line number 29. Let's check it out. This is dollar sign. This dollar sign will be beginning of our variable. Let's send it once again. You see message showing reading player information. You see all the information about player.